John McCain's home state, you would figure this would be a walkaway for John McCain, you know, given the fact that he has represented it in Congress since 1984. But you know something? Let's take a look at the numbers right now. It shows that he does not have a double-digit lead. In fact, John McCain only has a 7-point lead in his own state. CNN has confirmed, Melissa, that in fact the Republican National Committee is running robocalls in the state of Arizona on behalf of John McCain to make sure that he doesn't slip anymore in that state. There are a lot of electoral votes on the table, and quite frankly, if John McCain does not win Arizona, then John McCain does not win the presidency. But you know something? Let's stay out west. Let's go to Nevada, which of course is a battleground state, a state that was won by George Bush back in 2004. Right now, there's a 7-point lead for Barack Obama. You know, obviously there's a lot of issues out west, water issues, land issues, and John McCain has tried to make the argument that he understands the West, Melissa, but yet Barack Obama has a 7-point lead in that state.
Hey, Mark, from the West, let's go to the East Coast, North Carolina. Obama has outspent, well outspent, McCain in that state, and people, our viewers, can track how much he spent, in fact, on our political pages of the website. But how is Obama faring right now? Is it paying off?
Absolutely. Look, I think you nailed it right on the head. He is up 6 points right now, as we can see on the screen, over John McCain in North Carolina. This should be a reliably Republican state, but yet Barack Obama is polling better. And on Election Day, the interesting thing that we'll all be looking for is how high will the African-American vote be in that state. So right now, John McCain is against the ropes in North Carolina. 5 days left. He could still win the state. But yet, Barack Obama seems to be doing pretty well.
Now, Ohio, McCain actually has a bus trip through that state today, and Obama is, in the meantime, in Florida, that battleground state. But it seems that in Ohio, it's pretty close.
It is pretty close. Look, it's 4 points right there. The state is absolutely up for grabs. You know, it was where George Bush won the presidency, re-election back in 2004. They're spending a lot of time, they're spending a lot of money, and I think that state is still up for grabs.
And out of Pennsylvania this morning, the governor actually called Obama back to the state saying, you know, I need you to continue to talk to the surrogates here, to talk to the potential supporters. And McCain, in the meantime, continues to stress the importance of that state for his strategy.
Yeah, absolutely. And a lot of people say, including a former governor as well, a former governor, Tom Ridge, who's a Republican, who's a co-chairman of McCain's campaign, that if McCain doesn't win Pennsylvania, then McCain doesn't win the White House. But as we see by those numbers, Barack Obama has a double-digit lead over John McCain in that state. Now, of course, John McCain is really trying to appeal, Melissa, to those voters who might still be upset by Obama's comments back in the primary, what he said that people in small town Americas are clinging to their
right.
guns and religion because they are upset about the economy and losing jobs.
And looking at the importance of that state for both campaigns, I guess McCain's ticket, Palin in particular, and also Biden have events scheduled in the very same city today.
Imagine that. That actually happens quite frequently, where you'll see candidates miss each other by just a few hours, but it shows you how much time and how much money they are going to put into Pennsylvania, no question.
Okay, speaking of money, let's talk about the money that was spent last night on Senator Barack Obama's amazing effort to really connect with voters. He spent, between $3 million and $5 million on 7 television networks?
Yeah, unbelievable, right? I mean, almost unprecedented, but this campaign has been unprecedented. Mm-hmm. I would say that it's probably on the north side of that number, probably close to $5 million. He ran this infomercial, this 30-minute infomercial, if our viewers didn't see it. Of course, we did not play it on CNN, and we'll explain why in a moment. But it played on NBC and Fox and CBS and MSNBC and BET and Univision, as well as TV One. So talk about like really trying to blanket the airwaves and try to hit every demographic group you possibly could. That's what Barack Obama did last night. Now, for the first 27 minutes of that infomercial, Barack Obama had people giving testimonies talking about how he would be a good president, as well as Barack Obama talking about some major issues, including taxes. And let's hear a little bit of what he had to say about taxes.
As president, here's what I'll do. Cut taxes for every working family making less than $200,000 a year. Give businesses a tax credit for every new employee that they hire right here in the U.S. over the next 2 years. And eliminate tax breaks for companies that ship jobs overseas. Help homeowners who are making a good faith effort to pay their mortgages by freezing foreclosures for 90 days. And just like after 9/11, we'll provide low-cost loans to help small businesses pay their workers and keep their doors open. None of that grows government. It grows the economy and keeps people on the job. This is what we can do right now to restore fairness to the American economy and fulfill our commitments to the American people.
That's a portion of what he had to say about taxes last night. The 30-minute ad, infomercial, whatever you want to call it, wrapped up with a live campaign event from Florida as well. And we also saw Clinton in that as well, Mr. Bill Clinton. What's the importance of having him there?
Huge. Very big, and they did a big rally afterwards. Look, there had been a lot of talk during the primary that Bill Clinton and Barack Obama did not like each other. There were some very nasty words. Of course, there was a tough primary between Bill Clinton's wife, Hillary, and Barack Obama. The fact of the matter is, even though people were very upset with Bill Clinton and perhaps some of the things he said during the primary, he is still beloved by the Democratic base. And when you see Bill Clinton take the stage, really, he has this gift that he can connect with voters. And when he goes out there and he tells perhaps those undecided Reagan Democrats, these conservative Democrats who live in states such as Indiana, North Carolina, Ohio, Pennsylvania, that Barack Obama needs to be president, that probably means a lot to them.
Of course, not everybody had the opportunity to watch last night. Barack Obama talked about a lot of people. A lot of people talked about him. No mention, however, of John McCain or the GOP.
Well, it's a good closing argument on his part. Let me talk about where I am going to bring the country as opposed to try to tear down my opponent. Mm-hmm. Let me let my other commercials do that. You know, when you do a closing argument, you don't necessarily want to say I'm better because the other guy is worse. You want to say I'm better because I'm better. And I think that's what we saw last night. Now, Melissa, this did not air on CNN. And I have to tell you, our corporate executives have told us, and now you and I have nothing to do with this, but right. We were told that CNN decided not to run it. They were approached and asked to do so, but that we preferred to, in these closing days, let our programming, our news gathering, really speak for itself. So that's why we did not air it.
And speaking of our news gathering and our programming, we also had the opportunity yesterday, Larry King did, to talk to John McCain.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, in the closing days, we'll see more of John McCain and Barack Obama on our airways. In fact, we'll see Barack Obama tomorrow in the Situation Room. But John McCain did sit down for Larry King to talk about his whole campaign, and a lot of things came up, including Sarah Palin, about his campaign. And he talked about being the underdog. Let's hear a little bit of what he had to say about being the underdog.
We're now 2 or 3 or 4 points down, and we got to 6 days to go to make that up, but it's not a matter of worry. It just, you know, we and I have been together long enough. You know, I love the underdog status. I just want to leave that status about the time the polls close.